G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and today, by request, I'm playing a little bit more King of the Hill lately. And today I'm using the MrIndependent loadout, and that is the loadout where I don't need my team, I don't need health and ammo packs, because I'm using a Latrange, a Cloak and Dagger, and a Kunai, so it lets me be very independent of just about anything. I try and pick and choose my battles, and when I need health, I find an enemy. Oh heck, even when you don't need health, you find an enemy. Whoa, missed him. There you go. Cleaned it up. Thank you. The demo man seemed to approve. There, it's that's the way you do it. Love it. Is he backing up to the health? Yeah, he is. But I don't have such restrictions. I'm free to stab him whenever I please. This loadout is very forgiving for new players too. You might not want to take the kunai straight away until you get your skills down a little. And you do have to watch because the cloak and dagger is a little bit louder than the other invis watches. But so long as you wait for a little bit of a chaotic moment, you can decloak and they won't notice. Let you plan things out a bit more. The only thing with the cloak and dagger, as always, is you don't want to get caught in the trap of, like, thinking, you know, I'm a great spy, I was never killed all round, but then you never actually impacted any plays or anything like that. You never got very many kills. You know, getting through a King of the Hill maybe with only 3 kills is not really game-changing, is it, for a spy? Come out of cloak, take off a heavy or two, and you'll be alright. Is this guy coming back for a lunch break? No lunch breaks, no. Decloaking around the corner. Putting a wall in between you and the enemy can help reduce the amount of sound they hear from it. Oh, stabbed him during the jump. Don't know if that medic heard me, so I changed direction. I don't know, that medic was saying something. It looked like he was seeing me and was trying to tell the soldier that I was there. I was on a scout disguise, and people ask me, you know, why do I disguise a scout? Because it's easy to tell the speed difference between a scout and a spy. But, you know, there are other reasons for going scout, and the main reason I do it is, you know, it displaces the head hitbox. But, you know, no disguise is ever 100%. You know, foolproof. So go ahead and just act as if your disguise is not working. So you saw, as soon as I saw that medic turned around, I was noping out of there and jumping around like a scout, prepared for the fact that he was going to be chasing me down. Is he going to send that soldier back to me? The medic's all alone. I'm a 50% scout. Oh, my own medic healed me. Oh well. I'll take it. He didn't feel that bump. He's trying to escape. Is my team going to let him escape? You've got to punish a medic. There you go. They did kill him. You've got to punish the medics that come all the way into your own territory without their pocket. 10 seconds. Anyone rushing the point? Nope, we're good. Just be careful as you're using this loadout. Just because an enemy's alone does not necessarily mean that you're going to be able to get the kill on them. And I think that's a mistake that a lot of newer spies make. They're like, well, this guy's alone, so I can just decloak and stab him. But, you know, if they are alone, you're also the only thing making any sound. But you get in a situation like this, they're trying to push up an Uber. A lot of battle sound going on. They don't hear the decloak. The last thing on their mind is to turn around and check a corner for a spy. They're pushing forward with an Uber. Let's try and get a forward position here. I'm high health, but I've got to watch that this soldier doesn't send a pyro flaming me. Oh my goodness. Move it up. Okay, yeah, I'm going to go back to the other side. Brass beast. Oh, gets sniped just as I drop out of cloak. Managed to pick up the demo man though. It's alright. Oh, yeah. He saw the two soldiers there. I gotta get out of here. See, there you go. The Mr. Independent loadout. Not needing the team at all as I sit on the dispenser. Oh my goodness. But granted, it was the team that got me flamed. Look at all this battle happenings all around, but they don't see me. See, the disguise doesn't matter. I could have had no disguise there. It was just the fact that I was trying to stay out of eyesight, and I didn't do it right there. The heavy saw me. But you see, he's turning his back checking for me, and it's getting him punished for it. Onto some offense with the same loadout, though. Because of the Lutron J, I am able to use this cloak for a very long time. So you can get about as much distance out of it as you would with a regular Invis watch. And I don't know, did that spy see me? He looked back here. That bumper got an enemy. Might have thought I was a crate. See, that's a good example. Okay, I decloaked without having a wall between me and that sniper. There was no other battle sounds happening, even though there were some targets coming at him. But he was able to hear the cloak and dagger decloaking. You know, it's just not a very quiet watch. And there's a spy behind me. Quickly get my back out of there. Oh, a gunfight. Showdown at the OK Corral here. Can I get a stab? No, he didn't back up into it. But you see how he still hasn't seen me. I stayed out of his eyesight. And that's the biggest trick to learn with a spy. Just staying out of their vision. Put a wall between me and that target. He hasn't heard that decloak. He's not reacting to it, and we're good. There's an NG trying to build up top. I'm in the corner here, not because I need the health or anything. I just don't want them to accidentally bump me. Oh, this guy spawning happened to see me. But I want to get up to where that engineer is. He has a named weapon. A named rescue ranger. Oh, Pyro's on the scene, though. No, Pyro took it out before I could do anything. Bumper cloak spy there, but we got two snipers in the back here. They are fully distracted. Whoa, I thought I hit that first step. Heavy and Demo both react to it. Oh, I shouldn't have done it. I don't know why I did that. Why did I even go for that health? I'm Mr. Independent. Similar to the Mr. Independent loadout, if you want a slight variation on it, is just take the Invis Watch with it. Invis Watch with the Lutron J has an extremely long cloak time. It's almost as if you have a cloak and dagger. But you get the advantage of the fact that the cloak is very quiet. That Pyro not turning, you know, he was looking down a heavy. But I decloaked without a wall in between us. I tried to see what I could get away with that spy, but it wasn't gonna happen. So let's take a look at these decloaks. Just see what I can get away with in this clip. Now this game I joined late. The cart was already on its way to the third point when I joined here. Oh, Gerard 8. Get around. I hate that you can't squeeze around the cart there. That is so annoying. Take a peek up. Nothing coming for the cart. See how long this cloak has been lasting. It's amazing. Still overhealed from my last stab. With this loadout, with the Lutron J and an Invis Watch, you can use a large ammo pack as if it was a cloak and dagger, because the cloak will last longer than the respawn time of the ammo pack. Don't know why you're trying to set up there, Mr. McQuackers. Couple of mini sentries around. Sometimes when there's a lot of mini sentries, I'll switch out to the red tape recorder. Because engineers with minis do not want to remove the sapper really off of the sentry. It's not worth it. I'll ignore these sentries. Relying on the kunai for health. Did that pyro see me? I think that pyro saw me. Yeah, it did. He's checking. I'm out of here. Look at this cloak. How long has this cloak been lasting? Because we picked up some metal as well. Who needs a cloak and dagger when you can do this? A couple of teleporters. Whoa, bad time on the spawn there. I just kind of want the teleporters down. Nah. Gonna have to try it again later. Oh, they removed it themselves. That's nice. Thank you very much for that. Murdered your toys as well. Ha 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 ha. Get a nice little chain here. That scout. Getting shot in the head. Ow! Where'd I get flame from? Don't really need to stop the burning, but let's get all the cloak back. Is that pyro not doing anything? What's up? You typing? No, he changed his weapon. I don't know what he was doing. Maybe he was waiting for something to come around the corner. Whoa, that pyro chased me. And he got punished for it. I don't mind leading them around the corners to my teammates. That's one of the sly things a spy can do. Lead the enemy into danger because, I don't know, every time an enemy sees a spy, they're like, oh my god, I need to kill the spy. The spy must die. The spy must be air blasted into the pit. See, just like that. Be very quiet. Oh, and the medic is all low. Oh, that critical shotgun. Watch the cart. Yeah, I'm watching the cart. I never stop watching the cart. The medic's behind me. I can feel it. Can we get him? Oh, it looked like my knife raised there. I thought I had the timing. I was just a little off. It's okay. We get him anyway. Whoa. Yeah, I can't survive another blast. 5 health. Need to find me a health pack. There's a big, tasty health pack. Look at that health pack. Nom, 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 nom. Delicious. Watch the cart. He keeps just spamming that watch the cart. You gotta watch that you're not the boy who cries wolf. Oh, dang it. Bump. I'm bump forward. I'm bump backwards. I'm just gonna stand still and die. Stab! No, no escape for you. This spot is actually really nice. You see me use it often. It's just out of the way and they don't look at it. I can decloak in there in safety. Oh, flaming me again. Is he gonna come around the corner? Yeah, he is. I think he... No, he got sniped. One of the pyros got sniped. See, he's too busy to notice that decloak. Nice, quiet decloak. Masking the decloak with the sound. Whoa, bump. They would have seen that. But we had a heavy there, so maybe he's going to give enough distraction for us. Don't feel me. Don't feel that. Thank you. That sniper seems like he's a little new, so I'll take his health. Taking direct hits at my sentries and buildings. We can't have that. Nor that. So if you want something different from really aggressive Dead Ringer play, I really recommend the Latrange with an Invis Watch. It lets you be really, really sneaky. See, decloaking right in the middle of 5 of them because they were too busy. The sentry gun's not a problem because of the kunai. But like I'm saying, if you are just learning this, probably don't take the kunai. The kunai is not very forgiving if you make a mistake, so take a regular knife till you get the feel for the watch and the revolver, but then switch it out to a kunai. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Non più dry farfalloni amoroso, notte giorno di torno girando, delle belle turbando a riposo, ma ci sento a dolcino d'amor.